we have a very special program for you. With us is the Inner City Ensemble, a theater and dance group from Paterson, New Jersey, that has been working and training teenagers in the performing arts since 1973. Welcome to Imágenes Latinas. Saludos, amigos televidentes. I'm Luis Alonso. The Inner City Ensemble has received much recognition in New Jersey, as well as in New York and Puerto Rico. Many of its members have gone to perform and study in such prestigious institutions like Juilliard, the Joffrey Ballet, Westminster Choir College, the Avinelli Second Dance Companies, and New York University. Later in the program, we'll have an opportunity to talk with the group's director, Mr. Ralph Gomez, and learn more about the Inner City Ensemble. But for now, let's focus on a duet performed by Marin Delgado and Timothy Armour, followed by a drama directed by Ralph Gomez. I leave you with the Inner City Ensemble.
Anything except one thing.
What one thing?
We're not allowed to eat from the tree.
Not allowed to eat?
We may not even touch it.
Not even touch?
Not touch?
Why not even touch?
Adam said I would die.
If you touch the tree.
Adam said.
If you even touch the tree, you will die.
But.
Have you died?
I don't know.
You touched the tree. And you haven't died.
You haven't died.
But Adam said.
Adam said.
Listen. Answer me this.
Could it hurt more to eat than to touch?
To eat than to touch?
Could it?
It is forbidden.
Who has forbidden it?
Who?
God.
And why?
Why has he forbidden it?
Why?
Why does he set limits against
you and Adam?
Think.
God's property?
Is it?
He says Adam and Eve may not eat. But are not Adam and Eve guests in this garden?
Are they guests?
Don't they live here?
May they not eat where they want?
I don't know.
Also, haven't you noticed that the younger have always ruled over the elder creation?
Over the elder creation?
Haven't you noticed? And aren't you afraid?
Aren't you afraid? And hadn't you better hurry
and eat the fruit now before the next comes to rule over you?
I'm not afraid.
Oh, she's not afraid.
Why should she be?
Look, how could she be?
How?
She couldn't be. She doesn't know.
Doesn't know what?
Well, doesn't know she exists.
And why doesn't she know it?
Because she hasn't eaten.
If she'd eaten, she'd know.
Know what?
What world she would know if she ate.
What world?
If she'd eaten, she'd know.
And if she knew, she could.
What? You don't know.
Because you haven't eaten.
Do you know?
I don't know.
I don't.
But I can imagine.
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 But is what you can imagine what will be?
How can you know until you eat?
How can I know?
How can I know until you eat?
This garden.
And all these plants.
And all these animals
were once only imagined.
Shall I risk losing all of these?
It may be.
It may be that no garden
is better than this one.
This garden.
It may be.
But you won't know.
You can't know until you eat.
How could you know?
If I eat, and if I die, will you die too?
If you die, I will die too.
Why do you want me to eat?
Because I want to.
I want to know.
Know what?
Know what you will know.
Know what will happen.
I might do it. I might do it if God didn't know.
You might
do it if God didn't know. But you want to.
And he knows you want to. Is a crime.
Only a crime.
When you're caught.
Shall I do what I want to then?
Yes!
Even if what I want is to listen to God and not to you?
Yes!
If you want.
If you want.
Yes?
Then I will eat. Because I want to.
And Eve looked at the creatures in the garden, and at the ground, and at the wind and the water, and she said, I am not the same as these. And she began to examine her skin and her eyes and her ears and her nose and her mouth. And she began to examine her own mind. Then Eve went to Adam to persuade Adam to eat. But Adam said, you have eaten of that which was forbidden, and you shall die. Do you want me to eat and die too? But Adam. Adam ate. And Adam looked at the creatures in the garden, and at the ground, and at the wind and the water. And he said, I am not the same as these. He began to examine his skin and his eyes. Exhausted, they reached the cliff and threw themselves into the sea.
We're here with Ralph Gomez, who is the founder and director of the Inner City Ensemble. And it's a pleasure to have you in our show, Ralph. One of the things that I've been reading about the Inner City Ensemble is that you have been able to accomplish so much since 1973. Your company has performed for over 150,000 people. Your teaching techniques have been approved by the State Department of Education. The students that participate here get credits for their participation by the Patterson's Board of Education. How have you been able to accomplish all this?
Well, it's quite a long story. I guess I would first respond to that by saying that it's come after a tremendous amount of work and dedication on the part of a very professional staff and on the part of the students, naturally, and the cooperation of their parents as well. The program began in 1973, and at that time, I had a dream, which was to provide teenagers with an alternative to the city streets, which I think often breed despair, violence, and loneliness. And also, in turn, I had hoped to provide them with a program where they could receive professional training in the arts so that they could discover their own potential for creative work and perhaps go into professional careers in the arts. So I began working with these teenagers and designing performances for them, and we receive overwhelming responses from people in the community, from the educational community, the political community, and parents as well. And the program began mushrooming, and we receive funding and support that is so very important. And today we are a professional training program in both the areas of theater and dance, and we have a very fine track record, as you know.
You talked about professional training. How professional is that professional training?
Well, the ensemble students work with professional actors and dancers from the theater world. They are people who come from a wide variety of professional experiences on the stage, stemming from the Broadway stage to concert dance companies. And they're trained by very, very fine people who have professional expertise and experience in the field.
Talking about the future goals of the ensemble, I know that you are talking about the creation of a school for the performing arts in Patterson. Mm-hmm. What is the status of that?
Well, there are discussions and plans in the making here in Patterson for a performing arts high school. This is a project that I have been very interested in seeing through for a very long period of time. What my goals would be with this kind of a project would be to form a professional arts high school whereby the students would receive training of the same caliber that the ensemble students are currently receiving, where they would be trained by professional actors and dancers who come from very fine backgrounds, and a program where they would also receive their academic training in the same building. As you know, right now, the ensemble students undergo a very rigorous training program, but it happens after school hours. And it's a very demanding program, and it's quite a bit of stress on the teenagers to go through an entire day of school, and then to have to come to the inner city ensemble and go through, in a sense, another evening of school.
Yes. Ralph, it's been a pleasure to have you in our show, and I hope that in the future we'll do a show about the School of the Performing Arts in Paterson, New Jersey. And I would like for you to introduce our next piece, which is a solo by Marlene Delgado.
Well, this is an exciting piece, choreographed by Carol Payne Fish. The title of the piece is Portrait, and it has been choreographed in the Martha Graham technique, which is quite a sophisticated dance technique, one that the students have been training in here for, I'd say, the past 2.5 years. So it's relatively new to our dance training program. As I said, it is a solo, and Marilyn has been performing it, I'd say, for about 1.5 years now.
Well, we'll see that solo, and I hope that that School for the Performing Arts comes true.
Thank
here
you
in
very
Paterson.
Much. I think it will.
Thank you. it's been a pleasure to bring you the Inner City Ensemble, not only for their artistic achievements, but also because they stand out as a positive image of what young people can do when offered the opportunity. The same youngsters who could have turned to negative behavior in the idleness of the streets now use their energies to create a better future for themselves and for the community they live in. It is important to note, though, that the Inner City Ensemble is successful because an adult, Ralph Gomez, cared. We hope that this sets an example for others. And now we close our program with a dance performed by the senior members of the company. And I'll see you soon, again, in another program of Imágenes Latinas. Until then.